So this is just kind of a quick little what I've been working on with. I'm back at the gas station because gas station. So I had an idea for the gas station for a grill for Lil White to be working at. So what we're probably gonna do is we'll have to go downstairs to his controller, which is this one. Let's start out at 1. Bring this up to 4. And 5 activates the cash register. So I'll bring this one to 3 and bring this one to 1. Then 3. Then 4. Then 1. Right? See how that looks. So he's working the grill, comes over. Can I take your order? Yeah, that'd be $4.50. Let me just hit that boing. So how's your day? All that jazz. And back to grill. What was that? Yeah, I can put pickles on that, sure. Back to grill. Okay. So the grill is just a couple slots. So the burgers take up essentially 4 blocks. They will go in the center of 4 blocks, which is ridiculous, but I kind of have them over the grill slightly, not really doing anything. But I threw the cinder log in there, and there's some lights underneath that you can't really notice, because I have them on too low and I have the light above it. But he's cooking burgers, he's got the cash register, he's got his own radio there, and he looks like he snuck a sunshake there too. Vending machines don't work. The vending machines at some point have to work. Come on. But I can grab a sunshake there, I can grab food, I can grab fuel, and then I have just random things in these boxes. Wait, is there stone? No, that's all concrete. Okay. And my automatic doors. Clearly, automatic doors. And then I can switch them to manual. And back to automatic. And what was causing that issue before with the automatic doors and the kickout was this switch. And thanks to Woody for pointing that out. That these doors are actually something like 8x2x4, not 8x1x4. So when it would go out completely, this glass and this switch would interact, and it would kick that side out. Doesn't do that anymore. So we're gonna make a quick jaunt to the main base, because I made another change there as well. That just involves heading over to the road by the packing station here. Turn. Alright. And I changed my bed around so that changed the truck bed around so that the resource collectors are now further forward like they are in my second start world. It just bothered me that the two trucks were that much different. So I tried to make them uniform, but I love this truck because it's just everything about it has been just great. I never meant for it to become a daily driver. It is my favorite daily driver because I have everything dialed in as far as like the suspension, and it just does not want to roll either. It's firmly planted on its wheels. I can take things like that, and it writes itself. No suspension glitches to that. It's just two rows of tier 3 concrete as frame rails, a block of tier 3 concrete in the back between the wheels. And I did notice two things. So I added some chain link, so now I can actually just bore right in here and bounce right off the walls. Except for right there, because that's the dock. I can just slide right in here and just bounce off the walls instead of just going straight over them, which is a nice quality of life improvement. Then I also noticed that if you don't feed your glow bugs, F off. I don't know if they die or they just F off, but these seem to have F'd off. So I need to get more glow bugs and then put in a solution that sucks up their poo. So this will probably get raised up out of the water so I can suck up the poo without sucking up water and not have to shoot water everywhere. Then probably integrate that into the system here so that I have glue poop without having to manually connect it or manually collect it. And then I'm probably going to move this vacuum tube to the backside of that support, and then move this support over to the corner so it looks a little more uniform. Right now it's looks like a level of jank that I'm not too comfortable with, but it's kind of where we're at there. The gas station grill. I was kind of proud of that.